Knees under the shoulders. Okay. Try not to move your hips. Try to keep your chin in line with your sternum and your navel the whole time. So you're almost flexing your neck almost. From here, just squeeze your fists. And then you're going to take an inhale. You're going to hold the air low as you squeeze the stomach. So you're kind of tensing the whole entire stomach, your whole body. And then from here, we're going to start with neck flexion, looking down. You're going to start rotating and turning toward the left shoulder, looking over the left shoulder, then looking behind the left shoulder and up. And then all the way up and back. Chin is up. Slowly start to rotate over the right shoulder. Look over the right shoulder. Look down toward the right. And all the way down back to the start. We're going to go in that same direction. Keep the core tight. Keep the fists locked. Over left shoulder, back, over the right shoulder, scraping your chin across the collarbone, back to center, and let's reset. You can relax between those sets. All right, now we're gonna go in the other direction. Squeeze, radiate, neck flexion, rotation, scrape the chin across the right scapula, right clavicle, over the right shoulder, up and back, back into the left, over the left, left and down, down, down to the right, squeeze over the right, right and back, don't move your hips or shoulders, all the way up and back, over the left side, look over the left shoulder, cross or scrape the clavicle all the way down, and reset. Okay, let's get the, so you can face me, so we'll get the scapula here. So knees a little bit wider, don't want to be too narrow. Okay, gonna bring the hands next to the side. Don't let them leave the sides. And don't let your elbows bend. Don't let your wrists extend or flex. Okay, from here, we're just gonna go all, we're just gonna shoot those fingers down as far as they'll go down. And then we're gonna roll the scapula down and forward. Forward. Try not to bring your head forward or your neck forward. Bring your shoulders up, your scapula up, all the way up, elevating it as high as it'll go, but try to keep the elbows straight. And then back and up, retracting the shoulder blades or the scapula, and then depression, let the scapula go all the way down and back, all the way down, down and forward, slightly protracting. As we protract, we're gonna elevate. Bring the shoulders all the way up toward the ears. Try not to bring the head forward. All the way up, up and back, all the way back, back and down, all the way down, back to start. Let's go in reverse. All the way down, down and back, back and up, all the way up, keep your hands next to your sides, all the way up, up and forward, forward, forward and down, all the way down, all the way down, down and back, pinch the shoulders together, back and down, all the way back, squeeze them together, back, back and up, all the way up, all the way up, squeeze it up, up and forward, forward, up and forward, forward, all the way forward, press it forward, forward and down, all the way forward and down, all the way down, keep going all the way down, back to start, and relax. Okay, we can do our shoulders like this or like this. So does it hurt to go like that?
No.
All right, so move forward a little bit. Right there. All right, so start with that right shoulder. Try not to extend the back, around the back, kind of keeping it straight here. So make a fist with the both hands. We're gonna flex the right shoulder until we reach a block. Try not to extend the back and compensate here. So don't worry about how big the circle is. Just from here, we're gonna internally rotate so the palm is facing out. And then we're gonna go back and we're gonna keep trying to axially rotate that shoulder as we're twisting and making that circle all the way back. And the back of the hand will wind up next to the side of the body. From here, extend the shoulder till you reach a block, freeze here, hold it, extend it, externally rotate. As you reach back, create that circle without jutting your head forward, all the way up into flexion, forward, all the way back, down to start. That's one rep. All right, let's try it again. All right, shoulder flexion, the right shoulder, axially rotate as you make that circle back. Try not to open up your chest and try not to bring your head forward to make that circle. The back of the hand ends up next to the side. Keep twisting it though, keep twisting it. And then from here, extend as you're twisting it. Axially rotate, externally rotate here. Open the shoulder back, reaching back, back and up, all the way up, up and forward, all the way forward, all the way down. Let's get the left side. All right, ready? You can face that way. Right? All right, so left arm flexion, left shoulder flexion. Ugh, turn around, face me, please. What are you doing with the thumb?
Inside.
Keep it there. I didn't say to turn.
Inside.
Squeeze here. Flex the shoulder. Thumb is back. Internally rotate. Reach back. Keep internally rotating as you're reaching back. Keep internally rotating. You should be at the very most internally rotating of that shoulder right here. And you're kind of still doing it. As you extend, you're still internally rotating. And now let's go ahead and externally rotate. Reach back. All the way up. All the way up. Forward and up. All the way down. Left shoulder flexion. Axial rotation. Bring out the sponge. Drag it back. Keep axially rotating. Back the hand, shoot it down and back, back, keep going. Now go ahead and externally rotate, then go ahead and wind out, big circle back and up, up and forward, and shake it out. Okay, elbows. I actually feel it in two different ways. So we'll do the regular way first. Flatten the hands, try not to flex or extend, elbows pinched next to the side. We're going to supinate as much as we can. Thumbs are out. And as our thumbs are out, and as we bend the elbows, keep trying to supinate here. Keep supinating, elbow bend, elbow flexion here. Keep supinating, go ahead and pronate. Keep those elbows in, and then push away. Create tension in the whole body as you do this. Supinate, flex, all the way, pronate, elbows squeezing, extend, and then from here, let's go ahead and flex, supinate, keep supinating as you extend, keep supinating as you extend, and relax. Okay, wrists. From here, extend the wrist down, down and in. In, in and up, up, up and out, all the way out, all the way out, out and down, all the way down. Try to keep your wrist in front of your elbow the whole time. All the way in and up, all the way up, up and out, all the way out, out and down, all the way down, all the way down, 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 down and in and up, all the way up, relax. Ugh. Whew. Hurt. I don't know about you, but it gets me. All right, extend the wrists. Let's go out. Here we go. Yeah, out and down, out, all the way out and up. In and down, extend the wrist down, in front of the elbows, you're going out, out, out and up, flex the shoulder, flex the wrist, relax, go ahead and make two fists, okay, down, in, probably face me. Okay. Down. Start like this. Down. In. Don't let your fists go together. Keep your fists in front of your elbows. Down. In. You're kind of going like that still. Down. In. Better. You really have, that's why you're irradiating, because if you're loose, you're just gonna, your body's just gonna move wherever it wants to. So your whole body is tense here. So down, and you're bringing your, you're extending your elbow, so it should be at 90 degree. Start right there. Squeeze. I shouldn't be able to move. Yeah. Yeah. I need more stick. Yeah. It's a radiation. All right. Down. In. All the way up, up and out, out, out and down, down, down and in and up, up and out. Let's go the other way. Up, up and in, all the way down, out, out and up, in and down. Stretch our toes out when we do this one. Okay, we're just gonna go like this with the right arm. Okay, so left fist is squeezing, palm face up, keep the hand in line with your shoulder, then turn that thumb down as much as it'll go, keep the hand in line with the shoulder. From here, keep going, and as you do that, bend the elbow. Keep actually rotating as you bend it all the way in.
Okay.
Same thing, extend, actually rotate, externally rotate as you extend, externally rotate as you bend. One more time, extend, okay, fingers go in, squeeze your fists. Now we're gonna internally rotate, keep the fists down, and keep the forearm flexed all the way. You can go all the way, as much as you can. Let's go back the other way. Keep going, keep squeezing, keep squeezing, keep squeezing, keep squeezing all the way. Okay, externally rotating all the way, all the way. You can look at your fist to see if it's in line with the shoulder. And then from here, other way. Squeeze, squeeze that left fist all the way. Torque it, torque it, torque it all the way, all the way, all the way. And relax. Let's get the left side. Extend. Okay. Try and bring that thumb back as we bend the elbow. So you're externally rotating as you bend and as you extend. You're trying to keep that in line. Try to get your scapula away from your shoulder. Try not to. And then you could also, you can go like, I've done stuff like this. So let's go back to the grip. Other way. Other way. Other way. Too much. Does that hurt?
No.
Alright, so never look for pain. If that were to be painful, we would just worry about those wrist cars. Alright, so just hold here, stretch it out, separate all five fingers, just breathe. Up, just breathe into that. Now press all five fingers into the ground. Okay, let's go this way. Now if that's painful, be easy. So this is a very sensitive area here. So press the fingers into the ground. Okay, let's go back here. Now we're going to start pressing all five fingers into the ground, just about 5%, 10%, intensify the whole body, 20%, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, intensify your entire body, 80 to 100%, safest and greatest effort, pushing into the ground as much as you can, and then from here, gonna try to lift the fingers off the ground by leaning forward just a little bit, trying to get those fingers off the ground. Using the regressive angle, trying to get those fingers up, all the way up, press them up as high as they'll go, and then back to that passive stretch. Okay? Yeah, that can injure somebody. All right, let's get the other side. Just know your own limits. So safest, greatest effort at 100%. So, I mean, my 100% isn't gonna be your 100%. So don't, you know, if it starts to hurt, then it's, you're going too far. Okay, let's go about 5-10%. 20%. 25, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Whole body's intense. Abs are intense, other arm is intense, other arm, Everything is intense, 100% pressing in as much as you can. Safe is greatest effort. Keep pressing. And then let's go the other way. I'm trying to get the fingers off the ground. Lean forward a little bit. Trying to get them all the way up off the ground. And relax into that. Does that hurt? Widen the thumb and the pinky here as much as you can, like this. Feel that?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Hips. All right. When you face me, what you need to get your knees. All right. Hands and knees. Right knee to right armpit. And then you're gonna externally rotate the hip. Foot goes up toward the sky. Knee goes back and up. And we'll start again. Keep the knee bent at a 90 degree, like you're squeezing something in between your, like you got a tennis ball in between your thigh and your calf, all the way to the elbow. Back and up, knee down, heel goes up toward the sky, and then just bring that knee down. All right, bend the knee, go up to the sky, try not to extend your back or flex your back. Okay, knee goes out toward the armpit, all the way down and in. Let's go one more time back. Heel goes up toward the sky, knee goes out, knee toward the armpit, and all the way down. Let's get the other side. All right. Left knee to left armpit. Knee goes out. Heel goes up. Knee goes back and forward. Knee toward the armpit. Knee goes out. Foot toward the sky. And all the way down. Okay, knee toward the sky, foot toward the sky, bend the knee, try not to extend or flex your back. Knee goes out, all the way to the armpit, all the way back to center, and back up. Extend the hip, open up the hip, all the way to the armpit, all the way down. Just gonna go in and out. Take this hand here because we want to keep that hip.
You're pushing against?
Just a little.
Okay.
Keep the toes on the ground. Okay, let's bend the knee a little bit more. Bend the knee a little bit more. Okay. External rotation of the tibia. So the foot goes out. Extend the knee. Foot goes in. All the way down. As much as you can. Okay. Okay. Externally rotate tibia. Extend the knee. Internally rotate, flex the knee, okay, externally rotate tibia, extend the knee, internally rotate, flex, as much as you can, okay, out, up, in, and down, let's go in and up, out, down, in, up, out, down. Okay, squeeze that shin. Okay, plantar flex here all the way down, as much as you can. Down and in, all the way in and up, all the way up, up and out, all the way out, all the way out and down, down, down and in and up, up, all the way up, all the way up and out, out, out and down. Let's go the other way. Out, all the way out, out and up, up, up and in and down, down, down and out, out, all the way up and out, up, all the way up, up and in, all the way in and down, push it all the way down, all the way up, and relax. Feel that?
Yeah.
All right, let's get your kneecap. Your right kneecap. So you're not going around it, you're actually moving it. Slower, a lot slower. Go slow. Slow, slow, slow. Yeah, otherwise you're just passively doing it. So you're kind of actively pushing in and moving it like a clock or a dial. Go slow and have like think about what you're touching. Don't just rub it. Like you're feeling for inconsistencies, just like, you know, I feel smoother on the bottom, obviously. I feel pretty good on the outside. Inside's a little tight, and the top part is a little tight, it's a little jumbled.
Do you have a bony protrusion on that right corner?
Where? On the patella?
Right here.
See, relax. Relax. See, you're not relaxed. There it is.
Yeah.
Right here?
Yeah.
That's your kneecap. Right here? Is that sensitive?
No.
Is there any areas?
Right here.
That's fine. That's just a bit, that's nothing.
I guess that's it.
All right, let's get to the left knee. Okay. You're really trying to flex the hip too as much as you can, because if you're like this, and then you're gonna be able to straighten the leg out. Usually you can't even get the leg straight in this
right
position. So first, let's just go from in and out. I'm trying to keep those toes on the ground if you can. Really trying to grip the ground. Go slow. When you go out, just because you get out doesn't mean you can't go out further. But don't open up the hip, so I'm not gonna go like this, my hip. So I'm just controlling just this tibia here. Okay, let's start out. See, I don't have a lot of external rotation on this left side at all. Not as good as my right side. So underneath, give it a squeeze, extend the knee, in, flex, out, up, in, down, bend the knee as much as you can, out, up, in, down, out, up, in, down, up, out, down, in, up, out, down, in. Okay, one to the shin, plantar flex down, down and out, out, out and up, all the way up, all the way up, just up. Up and in and down, down, down and out, out, out and up, up, up and in and down, down. Let's go the other way. Down, down and in and up, and out, out, out and down, out and down, down.
Why have I heard time out?
Yeah, it's really hard to do that. It's good to know that though.
Oh.
All right, patella, left side. Go slow. See, I got issues on my top patella on my left side.
From what?
Probably from using it more than my right side, because my right side's not good either.
Mm-hmm.
Press, like press into it and go around slower. You're going, hear yourself over there? Just go slow. Just kind of focus on areas. You can just tell that some areas need more space. Alright, let's get the toes. Stand up. Alright, bring all 10 toes up. Get them up as high as they'll go. Okay, now try to abduct the toes. Separate the toes. Okay, now adduct the toes. Try to bring the toes together. Yeah, try to squeeze the toes together. No, don't flex the toes. Adduct the toes. Okay, now abduct, out. Just out, not up, just out. Now up, up and out, all the way down but the big toe. Everything down but the big toes. Try to get those big toes all the way up, as much as they'll go. A little higher, now just the big toes down and all the other toes up. Other toes up. See how mine doesn't right here, that one?
Mm.
So sometimes you just have to give it a little bit of like feedback. See how I do that and now they're up?
Yeah. Ooh,
he's
really up.
See? Give yourself feedback. Cause give them, pull them up. And then keep them up.
Ah.
Alright, now just all toes up, all toes down, adduct the toes. So bring the toes together. Don't flex them. Now abduct the toes. All, everything up. Everything up, everything up and out. Just the big toes touch. Just the big toes touch. You're gonna go down and up. Just the big toes go down and up. Okay, now all toes down but the big toes. Big toes are all the way up. A little bit higher. Pull them up a little. Come down, bend the knees, pull them up. Pull them up. Actually, no, look it. I'm actually pulling it. Yeah, like get it up. Yeah. There, now keep it up. There you go. Keep these toes down.
Look at your toes.
All right. Okay, now we're going to keep them all up. One toe at a time.
Good.
Pinky to big toe. Once you do it, start again. Let's get start with the ankles here. So let's, you can go against the wall or here. I'm just gonna go like this. So we can get all three parts of your we call it your tricep surae, because there's three parts of your lower back of the leg. So you have your gastrocnemius, your soleus, and your Achilles tendon, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, so right now we're getting, what do you think we're getting here?
There's something.
We're getting our gastroc here, okay? So we want to hold that for about 2 minutes if you're really trying to treat this area. See how your foot, you're going like this kind of? Okay, so if you're trying to treat this area, you hold this about 2 minutes. You don't have to bring your head down, you can just go like this. And then from here, we're going to do a half a step forward. So the foot's about an inch away from the heel. We're gonna bend this knee, and you're gonna feel a little bit of pressure. Actually, let's come back. Sorry. So we're gonna hold here for about 2 minutes, and then we're gonna start pressing the toes and foot into the ground, the back toes and foot into the ground, about 5%. Okay, so that's that progressive angle. We're pushing down into the ground, 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Safest, greatest effort, pressing the foot into the ground for up to 10 seconds. And then from here, try to get the toes off the ground. Dorsiflex the foot. Try to get the toes and foot off the ground. Try to lift the foot off the ground, even though you can't. You're getting the opposite or the regressive angle. Get it up as high as it'll go, and then relax into it. Okay, now we're gonna get the soleus. So we're gonna bend that knee forward toward the wall. I'll do this angle so the camera. Okay, so just like that. And you should feel it in the back of that lower limb here. And hold here for about 2 minutes, and then start pressing the toes into the ground, 5%, 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, and then you're going to try to get the toes off the ground, dorsiflex the foot, and relax. So we're kind of going through that a little bit fast. Now we're gonna get the Achilles. So toe goes up the wall. Hold here as passive stretch. And then same thing, press the toes into the wall. So up to 100%. So press, press, press. Keep pressing, keep pressing. About 50%, 60, 70, up to 100. And then from here, try to get the toes off the wall. Toes off the wall, toes off the wall, toes off the wall, and relax. Okay. Let's get the other side. So if somebody didn't have good dorsiflexion, like that, like their squats, and they would lean forward, this is what you would recommend, like them to work on their ankles. So we're opening up the capsules of our ankles. You might be sore after this. Like if we were to do these 2 minute holds and then, you know, pals for up to, you know, 15 seconds and then rails for 15 seconds and then back to your passive for each one of these, it would take a long time. But if you were trying to fix your ankle, this is how you would fix that ankle. So press into the ground. Press into the ground with the toes. You're trying to plantar flex. Trying to point the toe all the way, kind of squeeze that 50%, 60, 80 to 100. And then from here, regressive angle, trying to get the toes off the ground. Just the whole foot off the ground, not the toes, just the whole foot. You're trying to dorsiflex the whole foot. Good. Okay. Sorry. Just like that. Get that knee as far forward as you can, that left knee. Right knee, left knee. Okay. Yeah, trying to get that knee over the toe. That left, yeah, there you go. Feel it more in the back there? Okay, and then you press the toes into the ground. 20 to 100%. And then try to lift the toes off the ground. Dorsiflex. Trying to get those upper. Yep, get it up. All right. passively hold, and then press the toes into the wall, and then try to get the toes off the wall. Toes off the wall, toes off the wall. Dorsiflex the foot, yep. And relax. Okay. So then you do that one we did with our ankle, like this, where, like that. Like this. And then you can do the same thing where you press the toes down and then try to get the toes up. So that would be a lot of ankle work. Then for knees, that's when we would do, hold this. So you're working on external tibia rotation. So you'd start with an internal passive hold. And then you create that tension between the hand and the foot.
As you push out?
Yeah. So don't let it go out. Yeah. Isometric. You're trying to go out, you're trying to pull it in at the same time. And then the regressive would just be to go like this, squeeze, and then turn that toe in without, yeah. And then this would be the passive, which would be more like that, relaxed. And then external rotation. Ooh. See, I gotta be easy on my external tibia rotation because this is where I've had the injuries. But this is how you also strengthen that area. So I'm gonna be passive. I'm gonna passively stretch, and then I'm gonna do a little bit of pals. So like you can do mini pals and rails. I mean, if you're really trying to fix something and you're at full strength, then you do the full two minutes. You do everything up to like the standards. But then like you can also test things by just like doing mini versions of like, I'm just gonna do just a little bit of pressure, you know?
Yeah.
And then a little bit of regressive. So you can kind of just do a little bit of both, all three. So passive, progressive, regressive, and then passive. Progressive, and then regressive. Okay. Do. So you can take your hand like this, flex the foot. Up as high as it'll go, but try not to lean back.
Mm.
So I'm gonna go up. Try not to lean back.
I try.
All right, ready? Flex the foot. Now you're gonna press this knee down into the ground as that foot goes up. Hold it here. Keep holding it up as high as it'll go, and relax. Try it again. Up. And down. Okay, now we're gonna pretend that there's a Coke can here. So we're gonna go up, turn it out, and down. Turn the foot out. Look at it. Yeah, so up, in, and down. Up, out, and down. Up, out, in. Tight. All right, ready? So your whole body's tense each rep. So you take an inhale, sink it low, and then down. Try to hold it up.
Cramp.
Cramp. That'll happen. Ready? Up. As high as it'll go, and down. Up. Out and down. out, up, up, down, up, out, round, down. One more, out, up, in, down. Okay. Breathe into that. Keep your chest up here. Press your elbows into your thighs. Look. So I'm actively pulling my...
Oh, you're on your ankles?
Pulling my ankle as I press down.
Okay.
Now, 5%, I'm going to push my thighs. At 5%, you should feel it burning in your adductors, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you're trying to internally rotate the hips as you're trying to externally rotate them with your elbows. Trying to push them down as you're trying to go up.
Mm-hmm.
Start at 5%. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Press it down, push it up, 80, 90, 100, as hard as you can, as hard as you can, hands together, squeeze the arms together, squeeze the knees down. Actively, externally rotate the hips. Actively, press those knees down, keep pressing them down, keep pressing them down, get them down, get them down, get them down, and relax. Okay. Alright, now we're gonna squeeze our hands here. We're gonna bring that foot forward, go out and down. Okay, squeeze up, forward, in. Okay, up, forward, out, down. Squeeze. Up, in, all the way out. Good. Okay. Like this. So this hip is in front of the knee, 90 degree. This knee is in front of the navel. Trying to sit up nice and tall with the back straight. From here, okay, we're gonna wrap it around, and we're gonna turn toward the outside, and then turn the other way. Turn all the way, and then the other way. Okay, from here, we're gonna bring the back knee and foot off the ground. You're gonna let it hover, and then bring it back down. Intense, up, and down. And from here, we're gonna go up, open up the foot, hold it, and then just bring the foot up the ground, off the ground, hold it as high as it'll go. Turn it back and down. Open it up. Foot comes down. Foot goes high as it'll go up. Higher. Hover over and down. Okay. Hover. Extend the knee. Back to hover. Okay. Hover. Extend the knee. And back. All right, just go like this. Okay, now we're gonna press our hands into this left knee. We're gonna grip the ground with the inside of that right foot. We're gonna try to open the hip up as much as it'll go. Try to open it up and then bring it down. Open it up. Open it up. Okay, now bring your hand out here. Let the knee go off the ground just a little. Open it up. Now I want you to press that knee into the ground and press that other knee out at the same time. And then back. Okay, straighten out that front leg. From here, you're gonna try to hover this leg off the ground. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, you're gonna try to open up that hip and then back down. Open it up and then down. All right, from here, we're gonna take this hand here. We're gonna see if we can get that foot off the ground just a little. And see if you can hold it off the ground. So bring your hands here and then try to get the foot off the ground. I mean, yeah, if you lean like that, but try to stay up. And relax. From here, slide it out. Open it up here. And then come back. Try to keep that left leg straight. Your left leg should be straight, full time, and then you're going to go open, and then point the toe, and then let's go like this. All right, now let's get the other side. Okay, oof. This is the torso twist first. Back leg hover, just going up, okay, up, and relax it down. Look where my hands are, yeah, kind of like kickstands. Okay, think of a kickstand as your hands, grip them into the ground, widen, wider hands. Wider, left hand out more. Yeah, all right, back leg hover. And down. Okay, back leg hover. And down. Okay, back leg hover, open it up. Hover kick. So hover, kick, back to hover, down. Hover, kick, hover, and down. Okay, front leg straight. Back to that torso. Try to hover it if you can. Can't, not gonna be able to. It's fine. Just give it a little bit of Try to just bring the back foot up like this. Just a little. Bend that back down. Okay. Then from here, we're going to open up that leg. And then come back. And open up that leg. And then back. Back here 90-90. I'm going to press on the right hip, right knee down. I'm going to open up the back hip. Come back down. Then open it up. Keep opening. And then from here, hands together, then open it up more. And then when you get here, I want you to press that right knee down and press that left knee out. Press it a little out, 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 and then back to center. Okay? Ankle over the knee, feet are out. Try to get it all the way up here. Okay, from here, squeeze the hands and fists. I'm just gonna bring that right foot off the ground. Pull that knee up toward the shoulder and then back down. Okay? Left foot off the ground and down. Okay? Hold on to that right leg. This point the left toe. Okay? From here, we're going to squeeze that right leg. Point the left toe. Flex the left hip all the way up as high as it'll go. Squeeze everything here. Look it, I'm like this. Squeeze it in, mm-hmm. And try to get that left hip all the way up. Higher, point the toe. look it, I'm hugging, I'm like super close.
Yeah.
Look, you're not doing it, you're like this. Okay, yeah, and then flex it all the way up, as high as it'll go, up, and down. Okay, let the knee go out a little bit more. By the calf. Okay, from here, squeeze it, and then we're gonna try to get that left leg up. Down. Up. Down. Alright, now we're almost straightening out this right leg. And then we're gonna go left leg up. It left right hip flexion all the way up, get it up, down, up, down, release the leg a little, left leg, okay, all right, same thing, squeeze it and up, get in and squeeze it, up. Down, up, down, almost straighten out that left leg, and then up, down, oh, so that was your hip flexors. You can also do this one. Hurt your knee? Does that hurt your kneecap?
No.
So then what you do here is you hold it and then see if you can keep that foot as close as you can to the butt when you release. No. All the way up and then relax.
Cramp.
Try it again. Sometimes you gotta put something soft down on your knees. It hurt?
No, I gotta get this.
Okay, then from here, you're gonna let go, and then you're gonna try to keep that heel close to the glutes.
Yep.
And then down. Now, you don't have to bring your hands here. You can keep your hand out. So I'm gonna hold it here, and then try to keep that knee locked, and then back, hold it. And then once you let go, just keep your hand near it. Hold it, So even if you put your hand there, like this.
Mm-hmm.
You press the knee into the hand. Can you do that?
Yeah, but I gotta lean forward.
It's fine. Press it.
Mm-hmm.
Press the foot into the ground. Press everything into the ground. Remove it. Press. Chest is up. Press the whole front leg into the ground. Keep going. And then now we're gonna try to hover it.
Mm.
Try to get it all up.
No.
Get it up, 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 and down. Keep it at a 90-degree angle. You're like this. Okay, now we're gonna go. Up. Press the knee into the hand. Remove it. Press the whole leg into the ground. Hold it. Press, 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 press. Keep pressing as much as you can, and then everything toward you. All done.
All done?